Yes, I can hear you now.
Sorry, sorry.
What's up, man? How are you doing?
I'm doing good. I just want to know why, who said the people I am and you are beneath you?
Rudy, want to steal that one?
Because I have a radio show and I'm allowed to say whatever I want.
You're in trouble now, Rudy.
They think having a radio show puts you above people, is that right?
Most definitely.
Yeah, I think so too.
I'm definitely not being sarcastic right now. I'm
something larger than what you do, like, say, a bigger radio station or, you know, or MTV. Do you think they're above you?
Yes.
Yes, most definitely. And I'm not being sarcastic.
Is that where you'd eventually like to be?
Yes, most definitely.
Chad, I don't agree with them.
Yeah, I don't agree with that either.
I don't agree with anyone taking me seriously.
Well, I mean, you are broadcasting to a lot of people, and I...
Chad, you have to understand that...
As well, so.
And so did the Nazis, but...
What, dude, okay, how come... Rudy, how come every day I can't talk to you for more than 5 minutes without talking about the Nazis? Look, we have Chad here from a big band, CKY. Chad, we were just kidding. Chad, you have to understand that Rudy has a good sense of humor, that... It passes over some people, but...
He's too loud on the mic. He's louder than you guys. Just figure it out. But either way...
I will try to speak lower.
You're screaming into it. We hear you. It's cool.
All right. Excellent, dude.
Excellent.
So, Chad...
I'm a short guy, so I have to speak louder to make my point. I'm only 5'7".
Chad, Mark
is... I want to thank Mark for setting it up, and I want to thank Dan, yeah. Thanks for, giving the opportunity to Mark and the Alliance.
Yo, I want to know how your tailbone is doing, man.
How my tailbone?
Yeah, we're all wondering. How you doing, man?
It's actually called my sacrum.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, if we want to get technical.
I know about this. I took anatomy.
the sacrum. It's fine, man. People said I fell downstairs. I didn't actually fall down the stairs. I fell, like, 20 feet down.
Oh, really?
Onto stairs.
Okay.
So,
That's cool.
Was funny.
So when are you guys starting back up?
It didn't really work out. What?
So when are you guys starting back up, back on tour again?
We got a couple radio shows to do, you know.
Yeah.
Like, we put on live shows here at WMUC, and I'm pretty sure they'd be happy.
Once Rudy leaves the building, maybe we'll come play.
Yeah, that would be so awesome, dude.
If you have a Sunday free, it's every Sunday night, 6 to 9. If you just email, or I could set it up if you guys are interested.
Yeah, you're in Maryland, right? I'm calling from California.
Oh, yeah, in College Park. Oh, no wonder. Do you guys come here often? I'm
from Philly, but...
Okay.
Yeah.
I saw you guys at Nation a long time ago.
Tomorrow, I told them that.
Do you remember the last time you guys played Nation in D.C.?
Yeah, the Nation. I remember playing 930 Club, I think, the last is what I remember about D.C.
Yeah, I was at 930 Club. That show was good. Are you guys coming back there anytime soon, or?
Yeah, we're actually doing the makeup show.
Yeah.
Since I broke my, you can say, ass, it's like a curse word.
Right. No, it's not. It's fine.
Yeah, that one was.
I definitely think you guys should come because the scene here is kind of dying because it's being taken over by a...
That's another thing. I mean, what do you want out of a scene, you know? Do you want variety or do you want...
I want a variety.
It seems like every time somebody creates a scene, it's a bunch of bands that sound the same, think the same.
You're right.
Same.
Well,
that's not much of a... I mean, the whole scene thing is a bit clicky, you know?
It is, but...
I mean, just listen to the music. It's sound, you know? You got to find sound that you like to hear.
Right.
Yeah, that's true.
It just seemed that a long time ago, you know, mid-90s, early 90s, it was a lot more united. And I was talking to my friend, Pablo, who runs Fear.com, which is it basically unites the scene because that's where all the shows are posted. Everything from indie, emo, hardcore, metal...
I don't know what you're saying there, because I blocked that out. You see, you start saying all these categories, but I don't know if you're calling an indie band metal or you're calling a metal band.
Well, I'm just throwing out names.
Diverse. You know, the whole, just tell me about their band names, you know, that's what these bands work hard to get, you know, recognized as themselves.
Oh yeah, I do. It's just, there's so many different sounds that it's hard, like, you have to put a label just so people can get an idea, and
well, that's where it starts to become what it has on MTV, where you have, you know, 20 songs being played, you know, for 3 months.
Right.
You know, the variety is lacking, and it's from labeling it, and people decide what's cool, and everybody wants to be part of what's cool, so if punk is cool, which I don't know what they're calling punk anymore. It's just a four-letter word that was.
You're right to a certain extent, but it's not realistic. Because
how many more labels are you gonna come up with?
Past a certain point,
like that.
Past a certain point, it becomes
Ganalawaki. How about that?
Yeah, that works.
We could just label.
A certain point, it just becomes pretentious when you have too many labels, and I'll agree with you. But to a certain extent,
like I said on SCKY, I was in the DVD store, and they used to categorize things by alphabetical order. So I was able to find what I was looking for, and then they changed it to like horror, drama, action, comedy. And Spinal Tap, I was going in to go buy a new copy of Spinal Tap, and they had it in the action category. Now how am I supposed to find Spinal Tap in action? Like somebody thought
that's dumb. That is dumb.
And action, and that's because of labeling, you know, and you can't find the music you're looking for when everybody's so warped into this idea of having to do similar things to what's popular. It's a shame. And
Chad, I have to say, our screen, the computer is blowing up. All these girls are saying, "Tell Chad I love him." So I can't say all the names because there are too many, but Chad, a lot of people love you.
I love you too. You know, CKY cares about what we do, and we care about our fans, and we just will continue doing this. We like doing it, you know, and thanks for listening and everything. This is really cool, you know?
Yeah, dude, we love you. I mean, we love you guys, and
And it supports good support, because, I mean, we're out for nothing but good, for the good of rock and roll.
Yeah, that's right. What it's all about.
Definitely.
One last question. I know a lot of people have been talking. We don't know if it's a rumor or not. Are you guys planning on doing a 15 North show in Philly?
Yes, that was just confirmed. So
really?
Everybody who's listening overseas, it's probably 1 in the morning there.
Yeah.
What time is it there? Yeah. Yeah, it's going down.
It's almost, it's almost seven.
That is going to be awesome, Chad.
Freshfits.com will be like where you can get tickets online right now. And
that's going to be so awesome.
Yeah, it's only like a 200-seat place. There'll be drinking upstairs and all ages downstairs. And it's going to be a cool thing.
All righty.
The DVD, man.
All day.
When's the DVD coming?
The DVD, we're working it out. I just had to speak with a lawyer of ours relative to trying to get this deal with the label together so it's fair. I mean, that's why it hasn't been worked on for a while, and it's been talked about for a long time, and many videos are done. But dealing with a major label, you have to, since we signed a contract, you know, they have rights to the songs on this album. This album alone, we own Volume 1, our first album still. We kept that to ourselves. They had no involvement with it, so there was no reason for us to share it.
Cool.
You know, the reason, you know, so we take money from the label, they paid to make this album. You know how that works, right?
Yeah.
So, you know, we needed some cash to make a great album, which I think we did, so.
Yeah, your new album kicks ass, man.
So, this DVD, the money that we make from what we do, we put right back into CKY, and we've been making videos with that money.
Mm-hmm.
So we need to get paid back from the label if we're going to share, you know, this DVD or even be able to put it out. You know, it's we have to share the whole idea of it. So until we get a fair understanding of what we're doing with it, we have to be repaid for what we put into the video.
Yeah.
I'm just going to give them this so they can, market it wrong and make a bunch of money off of it and steal from us. You know, I just want to make sure it's all fair, and that's what CKY does. We handle our business. You know, we're very skeptical, and you know, we just want the most common sense people around us. I mean, real common sense, fair, even, equal, smart-minded people. And we think we work with the best.
Hey, Chad, we have a question from someone who wants to know, do you guys...
I can talk forever, man, whatever.
Yeah, what is this, Dan? How about you say this, Dan? All right.
I know this guy, someone I am just saying this, that you said that, this is apparently a quote that you said to some magazine or something. You said, "Our fans know everything sucks and they're not afraid to say it." And the guy asks, "Do you have any respect for other bands and what artists have inspired you?"
Oh, well, that's something you could just put in keyword search on CKY on CKYmusic.com. Bands that have inspired me. This turned into a very typical, regular radio interview all of a sudden. But I understand the
radio.
We are.
I mean, no, we don't hate all bands. It's a shame that the popular bands that are being pushed by major labels, which we're on, which I think that instead of them pushing crap, they should put their money in us. But,
yeah.
You know, what can I say? We'll just continue to fight the fight.
Yeah. But you know,
we should continue, sir.
You know, they do it through a market system, though. There's supply and demand, and people demand crappy stuff, and you have to blame the fans sometimes, too.
Nah, I'm firing our marketing guy, and I'm in the process of that shit. Sorry, man, I didn't even...
Why do you think these bad bands get played? And I'll agree with you that a lot of the mainstream bands that they get pushed and marketed aren't that...
Why are they getting played? Because they're fools, and they deal with the label like, you know, the label likes to deal with idiots. And if you're a band that's hard to deal with because you have a lot of questions or you want things your way,
normally
don't get it.
Right. You know what? Someone once told me that a lot of record labels, they try to force contracts where people sign off their music. And the bands get airplay are the bands that don't have control of their music after, you know, it stops being played. You know, all the record sales hardly benefit them because they've signed their souls away
in a sense. You know, like I said a zillion times on Ask CKY before, is, you know, we do not make money off this album right now. What CKY lives off of, and, you know, what I'm able to eat and pay the rent, you know, and feed my cats with, is the money that we make from merchandise sold and the money that we make from playing shows. And that's why the fans are the thing that makes this band. The records are something that it's turned into a product. It's just as a result. I mean, we put out Volume 1, but as far as distribution goes, we wanted bigger distribution and
we wanted
more people to know we existed. So we ended up on a major label. But
what do you think about online music and music downloading?
I do it
because
you do it. All right.
Yeah, so I love it. What do you, I mean,
so you don't think it's cutting?
One of the greatest things that's ever happened.
It's not cutting into.
You know what? I'm back into music. I friggin' hated anything. I couldn't listen to anything, you know. But now I got at my fingertips. I can research any band. I don't need to hear about it from anybody. I don't need to leave my house. I don't need to make friends. I don't even.
I mean,
as far as people downloading CKY. It's done nothing but good for us.
Yeah, I mean, that's how I got into CKY, and I eventually bought the CD just because, you know, I could hear it first.
Yeah, I mean, I would have to say, like, CD quality is better than what you may get downloading, because you never know where the file's coming from or how it was originally put down. So,
So as a professional musician,
if you're into the band, you buy the album. That's something that I still do. Yeah.
Right. So as a professional,
I don't have the time. I have a 56K modem. I don't have the time to download a whole album either way.
So tell me, as a professional musician, you don't believe that they're cutting into your profits or your living or the way you make your life.
I believe that this is reality, and what am I supposed to do? Pretend that you know it sucks? It doesn't.
Well, I mean, because a lot of people...
It's technology. Roll with the times. It's time to change. I mean, that's what this is about, change. And
would you tell that to Lars Ulrich?
Put the change in force and change.
Would you tell that to Lars Ulrich from Metallica? Who's that?
I think he knows, because his albums and his icon status, whatever...
You think his icon status has gone down because of his hair loss? Sorry, I'm just
joking. He knows who Lars Ulrich is now. He wanted to be famous, you know? The dude wears a robe at the recording studio. You ever seen A Day in a Life?
Yeah.
It is hysterical.
Yeah.
Right.
You know, it's almost Spinal Tap, but... no, I love Metallica either way. Their personal lives don't really bother me. And his stand on Napster, I think, was just an instinct reaction to something that he didn't know would become so strong. I mean...
Do you think...
Computers are really... kicking ass these days, you know.
Yeah. Do you think they're suffering from
who, labels or
no
band?
The actual band, the actual members of the band.
No, do I sound suffering? I mean,
you don't.
I'm happy as hell.
Yeah, but
this is everything I wanted to do.
And you should be.
More.
And people in defense of business would say, oh, well, you're harming the business. You know, the profits are going down. You're harming
the business.
You're harming the people's lives.
Business. We make the business. We decide what happens.
That's right. It's your music.
My life, you know. This is our life. You do it. Our fans do it. We all do it together, and then change happens. We're all going to get older, and they're all going to get older and die.
Yeah. I have a lot of respect for bands that tour and earn their money by playing shows and catering to the fans and playing the music they love to play and that's how they earn their music and their living, and they do it all the time, you know, throughout the year. And I have a lot of respect for doing that, because that's a lot more hard work than a couple photo shoots, you know.
Yeah, I mean, we're hardly in any publications, you know. We're rarely publicized. We've been on a major label for 2 years, you know. We had more publicity when we were with Volcom Entertainment, a clothing company, you know.
Hey, I remember that.
Yeah, they were good days. So, you know, it's hard to deal with this industry, but the point of us being in it is to have a voice in it, you know. If you're going to have a problem with something, get involved to solve it, and, you know, that's what we're doing. I mean, these people have to listen to me now. Instead of telling other musicians to shut up, go ahead and tell me, you know?
Right, right.
It's a much harder... They're learning from us, and eventually, and I do honestly believe that we are changing the industry, at least within our label, because they are numerously telling me a zillion times how different of a band it is, that they're totally not used to it. They've never seen a band like CKY.
Yeah.
It's just really hard for them to understand what it is. And for a lot of people, it's hard to understand what it is. It's rock and roll is what it is.
Yeah.
It's so, honest rock and roll. It's honest people who want to be, you know, fair enough to each other and are sick of dealing with, you know, with everybody's sick of it. You know that.
Yeah.
They're sick of it. Hey, this is the best form of radio right now.
Yeah, no, yeah.
Even if it's bad, it's good.
Yeah, it is.
Compared to, you know, the market brand, it's the boomer, you know, like, it's ridiculous. Somebody keeps calling on my damn other line. But,
they're not as important as the WMC.
Some dick from the radio. Record company, man.
So, what have you guys been up to in the past month?
5'9", I haven't grown in years.
Dude, wait, Chad, it seems like a lot of people on the internet are asking about sheep. What's going on? What's this sheep thing they keep saying? Chad and the sheep, ask him about the sheep.
I'm hoping it has nothing to do with what people do in their free time.
Yeah, I hope it has nothing to do with what I
think. Yeah, there's this, you know, I guess if you're young, I don't know, that
people,
sheep joke is so
people
lame.
They just start rumors.
They're like, you know, ooh, somebody asked sheep, is it?
Yeah, I mean, it was pretty. Better. It's pretty stupid.
It's an internet joke, which you know.
Yeah, it's just a joke.
Up. Thanks for everybody involved. I read it at least. I hardly read anything. So thanks for that. I don't want to know what that is.
it's pretty stupid.
Let's stop that right now.
It seemed important to a lot of people, but let's just clarify. There's nothing going on between Chad and Sheep, and all the online listeners. Don't worry about it.
I can't find a good looking one.
Yeah. You know?
I can't, you know. I've seen a couple who are close to my standards, and I got high standards when it comes to...
There's too many blondes out there. They're all trying to look the same, you know?
Yeah, amen.
Yeah, they are all blondes, and...
You know, all those sheep to try to bleach their stuff?
Yeah, they just want to fit in.
They're sheep, right?
They're all conforming.
Just trying to fit in.
Yeah, you know they're just insincere. That's what it is.
Ridiculous.
They're saying bah, like they're trying to say oi. And you know what? It's not about that anymore.
That is what it is, you know.
That's exactly what it is.
Good. I'm glad we've touched on something. Now play a CKY song or something.
All right.
Yeah, well,
I know my battery up, and if you guys are still on.
So let's see what requests we're going to fulfill.
Yeah, we're going to be on until 9 o'clock tonight, Jet.
I know exactly what I want to play. I want to play this Halfway House Hard demo. That
would be terrible.
It's terrible.
It's only
I mix and produce this stuff, and the stuff I mix and produce, I'm most proud of. The other stuff, it's, you know, it's cool that it's raw and everything, man. But it's not what we really wanted it to sound like. That's cool for diehard fans who are into that. But you probably got other listeners who might want to hear something else.
How about
pick something else, Mark?
How about some Shippensburg?
You know.
Shippensburg, Shock and Terror.
It just seems like a fan favorite.
Yeah, that's what a lot of people are requesting on the IMs, dude.
Really?
Should we play something that
went a little overboard on the pop side on the chorus on that song. I kind of took it into like.
Did you have a lot of oohs and ahs in that song?
No. There's like some, like Dern hadn't done harmonizing too much before on his old stuff. So when I got involved, I was big on doing harmonies and stuff. So the chorus in that song has like a Rudy and Blitzy harmony thing on it. Well, listen to that. Since we talked about it enough,
but
it,
we actually have one of our
poppiest sounding songs, and it didn't really fit what the rest of the album volume one sounded.
Yeah,
so.
All right. We actually have one Rudy and Blitz song with us today. We have
which one?
Carmel, my dog.
Poor Carmel.
Well,
all right, man.
Here we go.
Thanks for doing what you're doing, all right, man?
Thanks for calling in.
All right, man.
We really appreciate it.
Cool, I appreciate it. And I'll call in later if things sound boring.
All right, thanks a lot, man.
All right.
Later.
We're waiting for the other member to call, too.
All right. You guys, that was awesome. That was really cool.
You know, he kind of makes me want to play a song that some kids will not like, but it reminds me of bands that make songs.
What are you doing, Dan?
Dude, I'm putting the...
You know, making a lot of noise. Okay, thanks a lot, jerk.
Dude, let's play a CKY song, and then we... Dude, but he was... But they, everyone knows that song, man. I want to play... You want to play Shock and Terror?
Yeah, I think so. Shock and Terror.
Let's play a song no one likes, and
is there a CKY song that, like, everyone says is bad?
I don't think so.
Oh. You know, that's always fun, though, when people talking about music, and they always claim that their favorite song is a song that no one likes, just for the sake of saying something different, you know? Because they don't want to believe that every song is the same or is good.
Yeah, what I usually do is I just say, yeah, my favorite song by CKY is Stonefinger. And they say, what? There's no such song as Stonefinger. I just say, that's a B-side. I'm so hardcore, I knew about that. Yeah,
they,
you're on WMUC,
they,
dude.
They
what's
played
up?
It on the radio.
Can you do me a favor and shut up and play a song?
Sure. Thanks a lot.
Yeah.
All right, man. Who was that? He wants us.
That hurt my feelings.
You guys, okay, we're gonna.
All right, guys, we'll play songs. It's talk radio too, so we gotta mix it up a little bit.
Okay, we're gonna play this song. Then we need to play about. We need to talk about Betray My Trust. We totally put you guys on hold. I'm sorry, Sarah. Okay, we'll play this.
She just flipped us the bird, but that won't make us hurry anymore. So
yeah,
we're just gonna play right.
And
now.
She just flashed us too. That was awesome, Sarah.
Yeah,
thanks.
Thank you, Sarah.
And then we're okay. We'll play this, and then we're gonna move on to the next band, which is Betray My Trust. But now, here's Shock and Terror.